Hello and welcome to this session. In this session, we are going to learn how to install Redis on Mac, and we will go very basic step by step. So let's get started. And step number one is we have to download Redis from redis.io website. So let us go to our browser, and here I am typing Redis and I'm going to redis.io. And here we have this download section and we have this link to check the downloads page. And here you will find three versions. One is the stable version, the beta, and the unstable, where all the development is going. So of course we want the stable version. So you can go and download it from here and it will download a tar file which you can untar. But let us do it in a different way. And if you go down and they have given these commands to download, extract and compile Redis. So let us do this with these commands. And wget is something that will work on Linux but might not work on Mac. So instead of wget, we will do a curl. So let us first go to our system, and this is my Mac desktop, and I am going to create a new folder here and I will name it Redis. Okay, and let me just open this and keep it here. So now I will open terminal on my Mac, and first I have to go inside the location of this folder. So let me just first copy the location of this folder, and I will go to the location of this folder from the terminal. So I will say cd and this folder name, and now I am inside this folder. So now I can write the command to download the Redis tar file. So I will just copy this location, this URL, and instead of wget, I will say curl minus o and the URL and hit enter, and this should download the tar file in this particular folder here. So due to the network speed, it might take some time, and you can see finally it has downloaded this tar file. So now we have downloaded our tar file, and then we have to extract and compile. So again, let us go to the same commands here. This is the command to untar the tar file. So I will copy and just run the same command here on my terminal. So let me run the same command here, and you can see it has created this folder. And now I will say, I will go inside this folder. I'm just copying and running the same command. So I'm now inside this Redis 3.2.8 folder, and I have to run the command make. So just I will run the make command, and this will run some commands and finally compile our Redis. So it might take some time, and finally you will get this hint. It's a good idea to run make test. Now you can run this make test command. It will take some time, and also in case your Mac has a password, it will prompt you to enter your password a couple of times, and after taking some time it will run some test and give you the final information. As of now, I am skipping make test command, and now finally we can start our Redis. So then we have to start the Redis server. So we have to go inside the source and say Redis server. So before I run that command, let me just show you. We have this Redis 3.2.8, and now here you will find a source folder, and inside source we will find Redis server here, and this will start our Redis server. And we will also find Redis CLI, which will start our CLI client. So for now I'm just going to my source and say Redis server, and you can see the server is now ready to accept the connections on port 6379, which is the default port of Redis. And then on a different terminal, you can create a different terminal window, and here you can go inside the same location, which is in my case is desktop redis 328, and then you can say source Redis CLI. So this will start your command line where you can interact with Redis. So you can say ping, and the server has responded pong. So now Redis is ready. You can also go directly to the folder and double click on the Redis server. So again, it will start Redis server, and also you can double click on the Redis CLI, which will start the client. So this is how you can start Redis on Mac. The third step, which is run Redis server and run Redis CLI, we have already done, and we have already validated by running a command. In next session, we will see how to install Redis on Linux.